thank you for joining me today. For today, we're just going to do a full body general stretch. No equipment required. And we'll just spend some extra time along the way on any areas that I'm feeling particularly tight. So let's get started. We're going to start by reaching up overhead, making yourself nice and tall. And release. Fold yourself forward. Let yourself hang here for a moment. And walk it out. So you're into a downward dog or eight-frame position. Pushing those hips up to the ceiling. From here, you can pedal your feet a little bit. Feel the stretch through the calves and hamstrings. And then walk it back, bending your knees, coming into a squat. And stand up. All right, we'll do two more of those. Reach right up to the ceiling. Relax those arms, fold yourself forward, let yourself hang. Walk forward into that A-frame position. Push those hips up to the ceiling. Pedal your feet. And walk your hands back, bending your knees, sitting down into your squat, however that's comfortable. And rock it back and forth, get some stretching into those ankles. And stand it back up. One more time, reach up to the ceiling, nice and tall. Relax those arms, fold it forward. Walk those hands forward. Push those hips up. Pedal your feet, stretching out those calves and hamstrings. And walk it back, bending your knees, sitting down in that squat. Staying in the pain-free range, you can rock it back and forth, stretch out those ankles. And stand it back up. Take a nice wide stance, hinge forward at the hips, and reach down for the ground. With one hand on the ground, reach up to the ceiling and rotate. Place that hand with the other hand, rotate the other way, and repeat. Do one more each way. Walk your hands over to one side. Feel a stretch through that hamstring, pulling your chest towards your leg. Hold it there. And walk your hands over to the other side. Back to center, slowly stand it up. Nice work. Take your hands, interlock them behind your back. Roll the shoulders down and back, lift up behind you. Feel the stretch through the front of the shoulders. And then release. And repeat. Two more here. Job. Moving into the hips, take a big step back. Place those hands inside that front foot and relax your back knee on the ground. Just hang out here, let your hips drop down close to the mat. And with this knee, you can bring it in and out. Feel the stretch into the inner thigh. From here, come upright, place your palms together, and bring that elbow to the other side of the knee, moving into rotation. Press your palms together and pull that top shoulder back. Bring it back to center, placing your hands on either side of that leg now, and rock it back till you feel that stretch through the hamstring. Hold it there. Again, you can add a little bit of a pulse here in and out of that stretch. Excellent. Tuck your tailbone in, keep your body nice upright, reach that arm up, and even go into a bit of a side bend if you're feeling good. Pulse a little bit at the hip here. Well done. Let's switch it up, do all the same stuff on the other side. So leg comes forward. Inside, relax those hips down. From here, you can rock that knee in and out. Place your hands together, elbow to the outside of that knee, move into rotation, pressing your hands against each other and pulling that top shoulder back. Back to center, hands on either side of that leg. Rock the hips back till you feel a nice stretch through the hamstring. From here, you can pulse in and out of that stretch. Lunge, tuck your tailbone in, keep your body nice and upright. Take that arm up and extend into a bit of a side bend if you're feeling it. position, we'll move into pancake stretch. So keep your legs nice and wide. Getting a hip cramp there, not too wide. All right, you can push from behind or walk your hands forward. Go until you feel a gentle stretch and then just pulse in and out of that stretch a few times. And then hold the deeper stretch for several seconds. And repeat doing your pulses. And then hold that stretch. Position, or if you prefer, you can do it lying on your back. From here, I just want you to rock back and forth, feel where it's tightest. And then just hang out wherever you feel that restriction. And switch sides. Walking back and forth. Also can do this lying on your back if you prefer it that way. And then hold the stretch where it's needed. Excellent work. Let's move into some spinal rotation. Lying on your back, arms up to the side, cross one leg over the other, and let that drop across. Hold it there, making sure your shoulders stay on the mat. And when you're ready, switch sides, crossing the other leg over, dropping the other way, and looking your gaze back. Roll onto your side, stacking your hips and knees on top of each other, supporting your head with that lower arm. Take your top arm and draw a nice big circle over your head. Rotating, trying to stay as close to the mat as you can. Feel that stretch through your chest. And then bring it back. And go for five of these. Final two. And last one here. Let's flip it over. Stacking those hips and knees, drawing a big circle. And last one here. Flip it over so you're lying on your back. Bring your arms to cactus arms, pressing the forearms and backs of your hands into the floor. And reach up overhead as high as you can while keeping everything connected with the ground. And bring it back. Repeating, we'll go for about 5 times, nice and slow. Push your arms down into the ground while reaching overhead. 2 more. Excellent work. We'll finish off in child's pose. So flip it over, bring your knees wide, feet together, sit your hips back onto your heels, rest your forehead on the ground, arms overhead. Walk your hands over to the side and press that side down, feeling a stretch up your side line. Walk your hands over to the other side. Bring it back to center. Move into cobra, coming into spinal extension. Open up your chest. And relax. Thank you for joining me today, and I'll see you for our next stretch session.